CreativeGuitarStudio.com. Let's get things started with a playthrough of the shape that we're going to be studying in today's lesson. Today I'm going to talk about playing a shape that can be pulled through different steps of a key's harmony. This idea is based upon how every musical key supports the major or minor harmony on the first, fourth, and fifth degrees of every key. If the key is major, then those steps are all major, and it also works in the exact same way for the first, fourth, and fifth steps of minor. So let's get things started with a theory breakdown of how this method works, and after that I'll teach you all about the shape that I just played. Since our lesson is focusing on the key of E minor, we want to be clear on what's going on with the first, fourth, and fifth chords within this key. Now, the key of E minor obviously has a one chord of E minor, a four chord of A minor, and the fifth chord of the key is B minor. Now, let's start with the E minor chord on the neck, and we're going to use this as a shape-based principle, and this here will be our shape. You can see it's built off the fifth string, and we've got this kind of triangle shape of the G and D that come out, and then there's this diagonal that happens, EGB, going across the top three strings. Now, with this E minor shape, once you establish it, like any shape you establish, you can move it through the 1-4-5 principle. So here we go, let's move to the A minor chord next. You can see it's up higher on the neck here at the 12th fret, but it's really the same exact shape. And we can do the same thing for the B minor shape, except now we're going to go down a little bit lower on the neck. We're going to utilize an open string, but the shape and the principle of it is exactly the same. So what you can do is, once you establish your key and you understand what the 1-4-5 is, build a shape on the neck and then move it around across the 1-4-5 so you know what it looks like, and at that point you can begin using it to make some melodic statements that flow through the different chords of the key and give you a lot of options and possibilities for music that you can create using this idea.
Well, coming up next, we're going to take the theory ideas that we just talked about and we'll learn how they can be applied across the example that I performed back at the start of the lesson. But first, I want to tell you about a promotional offer that I'm running for my Handouts Collection ebook. I want to let you know about our Handout Collection ebook, Volume 6. This is my latest collection of study material. There are 76 pages of great information in here, and if you already are one of the thousands of guitar players who've received your copy, you know how great this collection is. Handout Collection Volume 6 is a 76-page digital ebook that you can download and print on demand at home. We'll email you the file within 24 hours of making your donation or a Teespring merchandise purchase. Volume 6 covers the open position and bar chords. There's an arpeggio workout, a harmonized keys workout, exercises on popular triads, a lesson on how to practice scales, and all the popular modes, including Ionian, Aeolian, Dorian, Mixolydian, and Lydian. There's even a section on the diminished scale, and even some jazz theory, along with pretty much every type of guitar notation worksheet paper that exists. The Handout Collection ebook is available with any donation over $5, or if you make a purchase from the Creative Guitar Studio Teespring store. Just visit creativeguitarstudio.com/donations to help support my lessons. Or you can check out all of our Teespring products in the console underneath this video.
Melodic shapes on the neck have options for fingerboard locations, and once we begin experimenting with shapes, we can apply positioned bass exercises that allow us to create different phrases every single day that we play these shapes on guitar. Now, the shape-based melodic idea I played at the start of this lesson applies the principles that we studied in the theory section. So let's check out that melody in detail and learn exactly how it's played on the guitar and how these theoretical concepts get applied to it. We're going to start with the primary shape that we have for the lesson, and the shape goes like this. And how it's working is we're coming off of this E note here at the 7th fret 5th string, and we move over to a 5th fret 4th string, and then there's a movement from 7 to 9 on the 3rd string that takes us to the octave of E. There's an E, and there's another E. Above that, we have an 8th fret and a 7th fret that takes care of an E minor triad up at the top three strings, and then we slide that note backward. It's a B sliding to an A. And we're just going to take this note here. It's a G and then an F sharp back to that A, just kind of to, you know, go through a couple of extra runs on those same notes on the top two strings. It just kind of adds a little bit of melodic flavor. All right, so that's the first shape, first idea. And remember, I mean, all of these can move around to the other degrees of the key. Like in this case, we're in E minor. So the next one we're going to move to is A. So we're going to take it just from this E up to this A, and we're going to do a new line there based upon the same format, same geometrical shape. So you can tell that part of it, it's identical. You know, we're just going 12, 10, 12, 14. And then we have the 13 and 12. Remember that minor triad? It's just that diagonal straight line over. And we're dropping down from, in this case, an E to a D. And we're getting a C note. We're going to have this B coming around to this D. And you can tell all of those notes, you know, that's kind of moving us right into the second measure there. But that's all the same notes we were using when we were over on E. We're just duplicating it entirely on the A. Now, however, when we get to that, in this case, it's basically 10th fret first string when we're dealing here with the A minor. We're going to slide from 10 to 8, and we're going to carry through the notes of the E minor scale. So we're going to slide to 8 on the first string, and then grab a 12 and a 10 on the second string. That's a B and an A. And then we're going to slide down from an 8 to a 7. That's a C to a B. And then we'll have this A note coming in, and then a G. And then we're going to finish on this 7th fret up here. It's a B note on the first string. So we're kind of adding a line that just kind of cascades, you know, position by position down the neck. All right. So, you know, the way I would function with this is, you know, map out everything, understand the layout of your shape, you know, the entire geometrical layout of it in E, I'd say first, then move everything up to that A and understand how it connects with that scale passage that's just on the top two strings. Then what I'd probably do with it is go back and just get that sound of the E minor once again there. And then I have an ending as well, and we're just going to kind of sit in the 7th position for the ending. It's a kind of an interesting sound. It starts with a triplet, 7-8-7 on the first string there. It's a B and a C. And then we go to the second string and we play 10-8-7. And those notes are basically A, G, and F sharp. And then we're going to come back to the A, back to the G, and then we're going to hit a D sharp, and then do the triad. Back to the D sharp, leading into the E note to finish. Now you can tell that sounds a little bit out of the key, and if you've been following things, we are in the key of E minor, which technically just has one sharp, F sharp. However, the appearance here of this D sharp acts as a leading tone. It's like a major 7 inside of this minor key. It's out of a scale type called harmonic minor, and you can tell it kind of adds a little bit of extra flavor there. And then I have this interesting sounding minor shape. It's a bit of a reach because we're going 9, 8, and then reaching all the way up to that 12th fret. So it'll be a good technical skill builder for you. Keep your thumb lower down in the back of the fingerboard if you want that reach to be comfortable. So altogether, That's that resolution shape. So all this stuff is going to be in your handout. If you're a Patreon member, you're going to get all this, and it'll give you a chance to really get some interesting concepts happening with the shape. However, in the Patreon video, we're going to dig a lot deeper into this and help you understand the movement strategy and just how to take it a little further, because I'll also have a melody for you in that lesson. So I hope to see you next in the Patreon lesson, and for the time being, work on these shapes to get them down and move them along the neck. They can be a fun thing to do. I mean, you can do it easily every day. If you're signed up as one of my $15 a month supporters at Patreon, you'll get to watch a bonus video where I'll help you better understand as well as apply these shapes across a worked out melody on the neck. Now, as a Patreon member, you'll get that bonus video, plus you'll also get a jam track to practice to, and on top of that, you'll also get to download a detailed PDF handout that has everything we do in the YouTube video as well as everything we're going to do on Patreon. So head down to my Patreon and become a $15 a month supporter today at patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. Well, if you found this video helpful, make sure you leave your comments and give the video a thumbs up below. The thumbs up really helps with the YouTube algorithm and gets me a few more views here on YouTube, so please give it a thumbs up. Also, remember that if you're looking for a step-by-step guitar program that puts real tested methods into a proven guitar course, not just random YouTube videos, it's all available over at creativeguitarstudio.com. You'll find a complete beginner's course there. There's a fantastic intermediate program and a very detailed advanced guitar course. As well, there is all kinds of electives on the site. You can study acoustic guitar, music reading, ear training, guitar technique, guitar soloing. There's a ton of options for you. Go check it out at creativeguitarstudio.com. Plus, you're also going to want to make sure that you're seeing all my guitar lessons here on YouTube. So go and turn on the notifications bell and subscribe to the channel. All right, guys, I'll be back here again real soon with another video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you again next time. Bye for now. When it comes to online guitar lessons, there's no place better than creativeguitarstudio.com. General membership to the site is always free, and paid memberships to access our step-by-step beginner, intermediate, and advanced guitar programs are offered in reasonable monthly and annual packages. Skype lessons are also available if you need more specific instruction one-on-one to discuss the finer details of your guitar playing. Sign up today at creativeguitarstudio.com. I've got 25 years experience teaching guitar and have written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to try learning the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player that you can be.